Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show. Ty and I are here together. It's been a couple of weeks since I've been on. I've been out of town doing different things that are school related, but it's so good to be back on the show. Students, quickly want to talk to you about academics. We're very pleased with the number of students who made the honor roll. Students continue to do a good job in the classroom. Students that are struggling academically with any subjects, or if you want a higher grade, make sure you go to Power Hour, Extra Innings. Make sure you get that information because that can help your grades. Another thing, we have a couple of Rand Pride winners. Sinesia Allen from Mr. Beaven's class and Gage Laston from Ms. Blodow's class. Teachers, I do appreciate you sending in your Rand Pride winners. Students continue to do a good job, so you will be recognized on our marquee and receive a small treat from us. Ty, what you got going on?
Well, you know, I'm still doing my best at keeping my grades up.
Okay.
And stuff like that, you know, working after school. Since you brought up a good point about academics and stuff like that, what about athletics?
Well, athletics, Ty, I think everybody in the county knows we have a very important game this week with T.L. Hannon on our home field that will decide the region championship. So, Ram fans, we need you to come out. We'll have an interview with Coach Early a little bit later and probably a video. But we'll need everybody to come out and support our team because I think they worked extremely hard this year on the field, but also academically. All the student athletes' grades have improved. They're working hard. So it's all the game they experience. You know, the cheerleaders, the band, the color guard, everybody that's involved will need to come out and support our Westside team. So Westside fans, you heard it here. We need you in the stands. You know it's going to be packed. So I suggest you get here early to support your team. Go Rams. Hello, Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show. We're here with Ms. Fisher. Ms. Fisher, if you could please just stand up. This is Spirit Week for us. And can you explain, you're a superhero. Can you explain who you are, though?
Yes, sir. I am not Superwoman. I am Super Avid Teacher. I was trying to incorporate our philosophy for our school with Avid and let everybody know that we follow the policies and we love Avid here at Westside.
Well, I know Ms. Dobbins is probably just ecstatic that, and she probably would allow you to wear this outfit every day to promote Avid. We did have a good Avid visit. We just got some great information that we'll be sharing with our faculty and staff that pertains to Avid. So we're very excited about that. We also, in the spirit of competition for the Hannah Westside game, I know we're doing a joint tailgate with Tia Hannah's faculty in support of Relay for Life and kind of supporting our own Coach Phillips as well,
because
he's out right now. Can you briefly talk to us about that?
Yes, sir. Coach Phillips, as you know, is battling cancer. We also have another teacher battling also. I don't feel at liberty to put that name out right now.
Okay.
I'll leave that up to them. So we're supporting them, and Coach Phillips issued a challenge, donated $100, and we've had several teachers who've met that challenge and several who've not been able to meet the whole amount, but they have contributed. We have invited Hannah to join us on Friday night. Friday evening, we're going to start between 4:30 and 5, chilies, stews, that type of thing. We're providing everything, and we're going to meet in the commons in case it drizzles, and just have a good time. And instead of doing a competition, we're having the challenge, and then of course we're going to be competing out on that field. We're excited.
You heard it here from our Avid superhero, and as always, go Rams. Hello, Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show. We're here with four of our fabulous cheerleaders. To my immediate left,
I'm Jimmian Mayfield.
I'm Jenna Krakus.
I'm Romani Latimer.
And I'm Olivia Sellers.
Ladies, we have a big game Friday night. Biggest game that this town's seen in a long time. Let's start to my immediate left right here. Jimmian, what's your prediction of the game?
For sure, Westside's going to win, but it's going to be a really, really, really tough game, but I believe the Rams will pull it out.
Okay. What does our student section need to do, and what's the social media? What should they do?
Well, they should show up wearing all black, bring your clean white towels, and just be pumped. Cheer on your Rams. Have more spirit than you ever have before. We're going to win, and we can do it with y'all.
How long have you been cheering, and is this one of the biggest games you cheered in front of?
Well, you know, started when I was in Little League, but it's definitely one of the biggest games that I've cheered at in my high school career, so make sure y'all come and chill out.
From a cheerleading standpoint, do y'all ever get nervous before the games? Because I know the players and the coaches get nervous sometimes. What about the cheerleaders?
No doubt. It's definitely before the games. Of course, we have our little prayer circle or whatever, but definitely before the games. It's almost a sickening feeling because you want the Rams to win, but I think we'll pull this game out with no problem.
Well, Westside, you heard it here from our four fabulous cheerleaders, and as always, go Rams. Hello, Westside. Again, we're here on the Kory Roberts Show. We're here with three of our senior football players. To my immediate left, we have Dre Gaines, Matthew Martin, and Baron Anderson. Guys, you know, all the county knows this is a big game. Dre, I want to start with you. You kind of lead our defense and led us all year with tackles and big hits. How do you feel about the game Friday night?
Oh, man, it's a very important game for not just for the school, but for the community. Like, we look at this game as a championship game, basically. And it is a championship game because it's a region game. And we play for the region championship.
I know Coach Erland talks a lot about the three things, establishing dominance in your area, winning the region title and the state title. Matthew, you know, you've been playing football here a long time. I want to congratulate you on going to the Shrine Bowl. That's a big honor for Westside. But from the offensive standpoint, how do you feel about the game Friday night?
In my opinion, the team that makes the least amount of mistakes and just do what the coaches tell you, because the coaches, they're working hard. We just got to do what they say and just execute everything that we do in practice, and we'll win the game easy.
So if we get the chance to go over the top with Matthew Martin,
We're going to take it.
That's good. And Baron, I know you were injured a lot last year and you really battled through some injuries, and you're kind of silent leader on defense. How do you feel about playing in front of maybe 10,000 to 12,000 people?
I think it's great. First time for us seniors to region championship. It's a big game. Gonna live up to the hype.
That's it. I think these guys have said it well. We're playing for a region championship on our field. We got three seniors here who've led us all year, along with some more seniors and some underclassmen. Ram fans, we would definitely need you in the stands. We need that 12th man. And as always, go Rams. Hello, Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show with our head football coach, Coach Scott Erland. Coach Erland, good to be back on the show again. I know you got a lot on your mind this week because we have what I would consider the biggest game this county has seen since they started the football. I've been around here over 40 years watching, and I can't think of a time where it's been this much excitement in the air. So first of all, we appreciate everything you've done for Westside High School to get us to this point. A couple years ago, we had one win prior to you getting here. So to be 9-1 with a chance to play for a region title in front of our fans, how does that make you feel?
Well, I think it's a great opportunity, but I think it's a very deserving opportunity. Our kids have worked very hard. You know, our three goals are always the same. We want to establish dominance in our area. We want to win a region championship and a state title. And this Friday night, we have an opportunity to obtain two of those three goals here at home. It's always good to be at home. And, you know, I look forward to seeing the turnout of, you know, the Anderson community, both of their schools playing. And I think, you know, our administration's vision was to have this happen one day, and it's going to happen this Friday night.
It's good. Now, I know it's been a lot of talk, but you've been in a lot of big games. You won state championships. How do you prepare our team to get to this point to play for a region title in front of this many people?
Well, I think you got to remember how you started and what you did to get to this point. You don't change a whole lot of anything. And, you know, coming off of our game Friday, I think that's probably the best thing that happened to us, is we've had so much success so fast. It's been very difficult, and rightly so, for anybody to handle that much that fast. And, you know, last week Greenwood was able to bring us back down to earth a little bit. And I think that, you know, so far this week our preparation has been good. Our focus is good. Our intensity, enthusiasm, effort, everything's there. We've got two more days to prepare, and hopefully things will go well Friday night.
I think they will. What do you need from the student section and the fans?
Well, I think, you know, obviously Hannah's going to bring a large crowd over here and their band and all those folks, and I think we need to show up like we've never shown up before and be louder than we've ever been before, except when we're on offense. We're on offense, they need to be quiet. We're on defense, they need to be loud. That always helps out with communication. It'll also hurt their communication. So, the main thing for me is I just want everybody to have a good time and enjoy the fact and understand how blessed we are to have this opportunity on Friday night.
I think Westside community, we'll need your support in the stands on Friday night. Come out and support our Rams. And again, Coach, I think I'm tickled to death to be in this position, be the principal of Westside High School. I've seen the tremendous effort that your coaching staff, you in particular, and the kids have done all year. So again, we're very proud of them. And I think you live by that motto, you're only as good as your next game. So it kind of sounds like you put last week behind us and had the team focused and ready to go Friday night. So Ram fans, you heard it here from our head football coach. Go Rams.
Hello, I'm head football coach Scott Early. On behalf of our board of directors, Superintendent Tom Wilson, Principal Kory Roberts, Athletic Director Raven Teague, we would like to welcome you to Westside Stadium.
I've always been told that I'm too small, I'm not big enough, I'm not fast enough, I don't have what it takes. I prepare so no one can take what is mine. No one can replace my mind, my heart. To be the best and stay there, sweat is necessary. I'm older, of course I'm older. That's the beauty of it. 16 years plus. Different level of wisdom, different level of understanding, different level of punishment. I want to live long after my records have fallen, long after rings have tarnished. Whatever you got to do to make sure you chase your legacy every second of your life. Will you be remembered? How would you be remembered? Why wouldn't you fight for the greatest achievement ever? Leave your mark to endure forever.
Me, I screen it, I'm only if it's convenient. You lying, that's shit. We pass around, that's shit. But you ain't fam, so what is this? You cuff yours and unleash it. Listen, I'm telling you, it's my world, I does what I wish to. If you're mad, well too bad, sounds like a personal issue. I walk in, they all stare like, who the is this dude? Kick's game is just rude, don't get jujitsu'd. Tunnel visions, I get ahead, stay solid, I never fled. My haters feel like I'm better dead, but I'm quite alive, getting bread instead. I just wanna stay broke forever, yeah that's no one ever said.